Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048. That's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
Hi, I'm Robert from Richmond Hill, here to talk to you about Midway Family Dental. I went to see Dr. Jackson because his prices on dentures were the best I could find in the area. Their on-site lab made my dentures fit perfect. With their low prices, I could also afford to get the implants on my lower dentures, which they attached the same day. I feel like I have my natural teeth back and I can eat anything. And I do mean anything. Dr. Jackson and his team at Midway Family Dental are the best. Call them today and you won't be disappointed.
The helpful folks at Harris Ace Hardware say thank you for choosing Harris Ace as your favorite place to buy hardware and building supplies. Stop by Harris Ace Hardware and check out their weekly deals. Sign up for Ace Rewards and start earning points toward coupons and rewards. You'll even receive a $5 coupon just for signing up. Harris Ace Hardware in Jessup, Hinesville, Ulonia, and now in Brunswick. They are ready to serve your everyday building and hardware needs. Harris Ace Hardware.
Our customers comes first at First Franklin Financial. It's not just a slogan, it's the way we do business. Since 1941, we've been helping our friends and neighbors in the Southeast with their financial needs. We offer personal loans, bill consolidation loans, and more. So stop by our office today. We're conveniently located at 1074 North Macon Street, or give us a call at 912-427-4237. You can also start your application online at www.1ffc.com. All loan terms and applicable APR depends on meeting our underwriting and income criteria for the loan size requested and may require collateral. Georgia Residential Mortgage Licensee number 5656.
The summer clearance event with no payments for 90 days is rocking and rolling. At Woody Folsom Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Baxley. Rock solid vehicles like Truck of the Year for 19 and 20. That's Ram for you. Remaining 19 Ram 1500 Classics are rolling out of here at up to 20% off MSRP. Rock and roll, baby. Get you some 0 for 72 financing through Chrysler Capital on 2020 Rams and nearly all Jeep models.
Don't forget our awesome free lifetime powertrain warranty. Good on most new and used vehicles you buy here. Good for as long as you own that vehicle. Ain't nothing to it but to come on and do it.
Hey, special rebates for first responders and military. We show our thanks for your service to our country. Better get to Baxley where we're rocking and rolling and deep. This is Mama Folsom's baby boy, Woody. Help, Debbie.
Remaining 19 Ram 1500 Classics are rolling out of here at up to 20% off MSRP. Rock and roll, baby. Woody Folsom Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Baxley. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Better get to Baxley where Rams cost less.
Local news on WIFO.
It's time now for a little least in local news and news. Wayne County Schools conducted their open houses today beginning at 3 p.m. For all the information, simply go to the school system's website, www.wayne.k12.ga.us. Once again, all gets underway today at 3 p.m. in Wayne County. It's the opening day of school now set for Monday, August 24th. That is voted on and approved Tuesday at the College School Board meeting. Vote was 4-1 in favor of opening schools on Monday, with board member Sharon Daniel voting against the opening of Wayne County schools. Others stated that they felt good about the decision as it gave students and parents the option of attending school in person or staying home and learning virtually. Once again, around 15% chose the virtual option, while the remaining 85% ready to head back to schools, which had been closed down since March after the board's vote on Tuesday to attend school. We talked with School Superintendent Jay Brentz.
School Superintendent Jay Brinson, decision has been made, vote 4-1 to start August 24th. Your thoughts?
No, excited. Looking, you know, it's been a long time coming. Our kids have been away from our teachers and for six months now. So we're looking forward to getting back in the building, getting things going. We know we're going to have some challenges to work through, but just excited about trying to get back to some sense of normalcy here.
As the board members say, it's a tough decision, but they gave this parents and students an option, so they feel good that the fact that they were able to get the option. So, you know, those that decide to stay home and do virtual are doing virtual. Those that decide to go to school, they're going to go to school.
Right. No perfect answers in this type of situation. Everyone's just trying to weigh out what's best for children in the community and their personal situations, as well as our task at hand, which is, you know, teaching children and caring for the whole child too, which is a very complex thing. So that's what we're trying to do. You know, the direction has been given to us, and we're going to get after it 100%. Proud of the hard work of our teachers and administrators. administrators to prepare. They've been working really since, you know, April to try to prepare for next Monday. So looking forward to just trying to get it started.
And the open house still set for this Thursday, is that correct?
That's correct. You know, it is a virtual open house. Our teachers have really done some creative, innovative things that I'm excited about. I've, you know, seen some of the things they have planned. So I think our parents will appreciate it. And, again, most important thing is getting that information out to our parents and to our students, getting them ready for Monday.
Okay. We'll look forward to seeing you Thursday on the Butcher Bob Show.
Thanks, Bob.
And, again, once again, he'll be our guest this morning on the World Famous Butcher Bob Show. Have more information about the open houses, also the opening day of school on this coming Monday, August 24th. Governor Brian Kemp on Tuesday announced the first $80 million allocation for K-12 school and college programs from his Emergency Education Relief Fund approved by Congress earlier this year as part of his coronavirus relief efforts. Statewide allocate $29.3 million to provide school districts with more options to connect students to the Internet, ensuring all schools have broadband signal extenders and expanding other options. $11.5 million to support mental health and student support services in the University Systems of Georgia. $10.4 million to provide more online courses and programs to technical college students. $10 million to support pandemic relief at private colleges, including historically black colleges. $3.3 million to expand construction training programs. $17 to $19 million to expand child care options for students ages 5 to 12 whose school systems have opted for virtual learning. Kemp says he made it clear that we'll always work to keep Georgia student teachers and administrators at the top of our minds as we address educational needs in the state. With the allocation of these funds, he says we're building on keeping that promise. We'll be back with more news after this word from our sponsor, the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
We're doing it up big at Neesmith Chevy Buick GMC in Jessup. We're talking big savings, big rebates, and one of the biggest truck inventories in the South. Save up to $13,000 on new Chevy and GMC trucks. We're even offering 0% financing for up to 84 months. That's how you do it big. See us today at Neesmith Chevrolet Buick GMC, Highway 341 in Jessup, or head to neesmithjessup.net where you can shop, click, and drive from the comfort of your own home, and we'll schedule your delivery. Chevy, find new roads.
Marshland Community Federal Credit Union is now offering Kasasa checking accounts. It's easy to earn Kasasa cashback rewards. You can earn up to $9 cashback per month and ATM fee refunds nationwide. To earn rewards, just keep doing what you're probably already doing, the banking basics, what we call qualifications. Simply have at least 12 debit card transactions per month. Sign up to receive e-statements and be enrolled and log into your online banking at least once a month. That's it. If you don't meet the qualifications 1 month, don't worry. Your Kasasa cashback account is still free. Plus, you can get right back to earning your rewards the very next month. Visit us at 333 West Plum Street in Jessup. Marshland Credit Union is federally insured by the NCUA and an equal housing lender.
When you have an accident, you, not the insurance company, chooses the body shop, and you only need one estimate. All you have to do is call Jerome Riles at B&C Collision Center in downtown Scriven to deal with the adjusters and insurance company. Whether it's a little ding or a major crash, that B&C Collision Center across from Wasn Cabinet Shop in Scriven, deal with the insurance company so you don't have to. Call them at 579-2274. That's 579-2274.
The county commissioners met Monday. They voted 3-2 to roll back the millage rate 1 mil after a long discussion, and a 3-2 vote against lowering the millage rate by 2 mils, which Commissioner Ralph Hickox and Kim McCreary voted for, but the other three commissioners, Herschel Hires, Boo Thomas, and Mike Roberts, voted against. After that motion was defeated, Kim McCreary motioned to lower the millage rate 1 mil, and Commissioner Mike Roberts voted along with Hickox and McCreary and voted yes, while Commissioners Thomas and Hires voted no. At the meeting, County Administrator Ed Jeffers recommended only a 1/3 of a mil rollback. And after the commissioners voted for the 1 mil rollback, he was asked for his comments about that. Here was his response.
I'm not going to debate all that. I know what I committed to y'all, and we're going to start reducing the millage rate up here. You got an obligation over here of that. I mean, that's a good amount going back up there. Listen, I'm a taxpayer too. I'm all about it, but you got obligation going forward here, and you got some, and we made a lot of progress to the hole that this county was in.
We have obligation to hold our word.
Commissioner, please, if you don't mind, I made a commitment to y'all to start rolling this millage rate back. and I've worked diligently to do such. I've worked on it. I've coached. I've prodded. I've managed this thing over there. Were we not in too bad of a shape? I mean, I'm just going to sit there and say, listen, I don't know where the demands of services are going to come from, but we can work it out. I don't know where the budget's going to be at, but we can work this thing out. And, you know, it's just going to be tougher. And I may have to cut some personnel or cut back on some things. I don't know.
Personnel. Mr. Jefferson, at one-third that you were proposing, is that a cutback? Is that a rollback, as you promised? Is that a cutback from the net revenue for 2018? You both know that's not true.
Commissioner, I promised you we start rolling the millage rate back depending on the digest growth.
That's not a rollback. That's not the net. That's not a net.
Commissioner, I never obligated myself to that.
2018.
I didn't.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman.
All right. The millage rate will be reduced by 1 mil according to the vote. Accept the motion to approve. So moved.
And again, the commissioners voted to roll it back 1 mil at the Monday meeting. City commissioners met Tuesday in a work session. They passed and signed a resolution strongly encouraging its citizens to wear a mask when they leave their homes or out in public places. It states the citizens and visitors to the city of Jessup are strongly encouraged to wear face coverings as practical while outside their homes or place of residence when other social distancing measures may be difficult to maintain, except when eating, drinking, or exercising outdoors. And further, the citizens and visitors to the city of Jessup are strongly encouraged to maintain social distancing and set out in the resolution as the governor's executive orders as well. Again, this was signed and by the mayor and city commissioners at their Tuesday work session. We'll come back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor, the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
We're doing it up big at Neesmith Chevy Buick GMC in Jessup. We're talking big savings, big rebates, and one of the biggest truck inventories in the South. Save up to $13,000 on new Chevy and GMC trucks. We're even offering 0% financing for up to 84 months. That's how you do it big. See us today at Neesmith Chevrolet Buick GMC, Highway 341 in Jessup, or head to neesmithjessup.net, where you can shop, click, and drive from the comfort of your own home, and we'll schedule your delivery. Chevy, find new roads.
Western Sizzlin' is open 7 days a week at regular hours. Their popular seafood buffet Friday night from 4 until 8. Breakfast back on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday mornings from 7 until 11. Stop by today and enjoy all your favorites from Western Sizzlin's menu or enjoy their amazing buffet 7 days a week. Don't forget the to-go window Monday through Saturday, 11 until 7. Western Sizzlin' on South 1st Street in Jessup. Now back to normal hours and menu 7 days a week.
For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
Since 1946, Murphy's Builder Supply has been serving the folks of Jessup, Wayne, and surrounding counties with quality products and knowledgeable service. Matter of fact, they feel they sell service first to make sure you get exactly what you need for your home improvement projects. And with each employee at Murphy's being there for 10 years or more, you know you're talking with someone with the experience to help you with building supplies, tools, paint, and all the things you need from a full-service hardware store. The best choice in home improvement is Murphy's Builder Supply, 156 Northeast Broad Street, Jessup.
Final notes and news. Reminder, CSX is doing repairs and construction today. It's going to take place for several hours. It's going to result in the closing of the Pine Street and Cherry Street Railroad crossing today. So, again, keep that in mind. That's taking place today. CSX doing repairs and construction. And, again, the railroad crossing at Pine Street and Cherry Street is closed today. On Monday, District Attorney Jackie Johnson filed a complaint based on information provided by the Jessup PD against the management company and owners of Briarwood Apartments here in Jessup. Over the past 4 years, Jessup PD has responded to 173 calls for service to said location. In addition, there have been a number of criminal prosecutions involving possession of stolen firearms, narcotic transactions, shooting incidents, theft, and gang activity. DA has appointed Atlanta Attorney Boniface Eccles as a special assistant DA to look into this matter several weeks ago. Mr. Eccles has acted as a special prosecutor as its court-appointed receiver in a number of racketeering and gang-related materials matters across the state. state seeking the court to declare Briarwood apartment homes a public nuisance and enjoin the Briarwood apartment homes from being a haven for criminal activity. The case has been assigned to Judge Robert Guy. Chief Mike Lane of the Jessup PD reports that on Tuesday, August the 18th, the detective division received a tip that Emmanuel A. Patterson, age 29, of Cumberland County, North Carolina, was hiding in a residence at Briarwood apartment complex. He's currently out of prison on parole, has several new felony charges, which occurred on August 7th in Cumberland County, North Carolina. Mr. Patterson's also been named as a suspect in several shooting incidents that have occurred at the Briarwood apartments over the past week. Uniform Patrol Division assisted detective divisions in going to Briarwood to an apartment in the B building in search of Mr. Patterson. He was not located at the first apartment. However, a 9mm Springfield Armory pistol was recovered after further search of the area and speaking with a few residents. Information was obtained of the possible location of the suspect in a new apartment located in the F building. Once officers were given permission to enter the apartment, officers immediately announced their presence and were successful in locating two people in the apartment. One of those located was Mr. Patterson. Mr. Patterson was immediately detained without incident. He's been transported to Wayne County Jail. He will be held until North Carolina supervision and parole can pick him up. Chief Lane wants to thank the community for information received, which led to the arrest of Mr. Patterson. Chief Lane also wants to thank his officers and detectives for working together and taking another dangerous criminal off the streets of Jessup. Again, Chief Lane encourages anyone with information pertaining to illegal drug activity or criminal activity, simply contact the Jessup PD at 427-1300. And that's going to do it today for the latest in local news. Sports comes your way in a few minutes. Bob Morgan said, have a great day.
You've been listening to local news on WIFO.
Our customers comes first at First Franklin Financial. It's not just a slogan, it's the way we do business. Since 1941, we've been helping our friends and neighbors in the Southeast with their financial needs. We offer personal loans, bill consolidation loans, and more. So stop by our office today. We're conveniently located at 1074 North Macon Street, or give us a call at 912-427-4237. You can also start your application online at www.1ffc.com. All loan terms and applicable APR depends on meeting our underwriting and income criteria for the loan size requested, and may require collateral. Georgia Residential Mortgage Licensee, number 5656.
This is Richard Johnson with Wayne County Emergency Management Agency. The cities and county government agencies would like to make you aware that all residents and visitors are strongly encouraged to wear face coverings as practical while outside their homes or places of residence, except while eating, drinking, or exercising outdoors. Thank you for doing your part to keep Wayne County as safe and healthy as possible.
South Georgia weather.
Here's your WIFO forecast. Chance of showers and thunderstorms early. Then showers and thunderstorms likely in the afternoon, upper 80s. Showers and thunderstorms likely this evening, lows in the low 70s. Tomorrow, chance of showers and thunderstorms early. Then showers and thunderstorms likely in the afternoon, low 80s. Saturday, showers and thunderstorms likely, low 80s. Sunday, showers and thunderstorms likely, mid 80s. Georgia meteorologist John Weatherby in the GNN Weather Center.
Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048, that's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
Tired of living in pain? If so, come to Smart Physical Therapy, located across from Dr. Hendricks behind the hospital. At Smart, we take pride in providing our patients with the one-on-one care that they need and deserve using advanced manual therapy techniques such as dry needling and manipulative therapy. Our compassionate and knowledgeable team can help you achieve the most optimal outcome. We will now be offering a free informational session every Friday from 12 until 2 on expectations following surgery. We'll be there one-on-one to answer any questions you may have. If you're looking to have surgery, give us a call to set up a free pre-op appointment. Remember, it's your choice where to go for your physical therapy needs, so choose Smart Physical Therapy. Our number is 559-2071. 559-2071. Again, 559-2071. Ask for Garrett Pye, Clayton Connors, or Nick Child. Smart Physical Therapy.
This is Charles Huffman at Jessup Housing Outlet. If you haven't been to Jessup Housing Outlet lately, you're missing out on a large selection of new and exciting floor plans from the nation's top manufacturers like Clayton, Fleetwood, Scottbilt, and Homes of Merit. All of our homes feature modern kitchens and appliances, R60 and higher insulation values, thermopane windows, and energy-efficient heat pumps. We have two locations to serve you, 2452 Savannah Highway in Jessup and Highway 301 South between I-16 and the bypass in Statesboro. Come see Charles, Faye, or Sherida today.
Stop creditor harassment today. Stop the worry of a pending repossession, garnishment, or foreclosure. Contact the Bankruptcy Group, Attorney R. Flake Cabinets, for an experienced assessment of your financial situation. They have locations in Brunswick, Hazelhurst, and now Jessup. They are a debt relief agency. They help people file for bankruptcy relief. Contact legal assistant Tanya Blanton at 912-375-5620. 375-5620 to set up your free consultation. Let the Bankruptcy Group do the worrying for you. Now serving Jessup.
WIFO FM, Big Dog Country at 7:30. Time to check your birthdays and anniversaries. Brought to you this morning by Bargin Power Sports. Fulton Tinker Flowers is 48 today. Fulton Flowers, Tinker Flowers, 48. Happy birthday. We love you. Love your family for Fulton Tinker Flowers, 48 today. Happy birthday to Danny Daniels, and Avery Mincy from the Robin Eubank State Farm Gang. Happy birthday, Danny Daniels and Avery Mincy. Long County calendar on this 20th day of August. Brent Kleindice Sr. celebrating. Mary Ann Jackson. Happy birthday, Mary Ann Jackson. And also happy anniversary to Mark and Casey Ray. Mark and Casey Ray, happy anniversary. Brent Kleindice Sr. and Mary Ann Jackson, happy birthday. Mark and Casey Ray, happy anniversary. That's your Long County calendar this morning. Via text at 912-427-3711. Please wish my husband Richard Sky Jackson and father of my sons Malik and Trenton a very happy 49th birthday, and know that we love you. Lots of love, Vicky, Trent, and Malik. Wishing Richard Sky Jackson happy 49th birthday, Richard Sky Jackson, this morning. Okay, let's see. This is yesterday. We did that. You've got time to shoot one in right now via text at 912-427-3711. Birthdays, anniversaries on WIFO brought to you by Bargin Power Sports. Let's check email one more time here. Kind of slim pickings today. All right, what else do we have here? Anything else? No. All right, wait, there is one right there. And happy 32nd birthday to our precious daughter-in-law, Cassie Robertson, today. Cassie Robertson, have a blessed day, and remember, we love you. That's from Cecile and Jimmy, wishing Cassie Robertson, happy 32nd birthday. All right, back with your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Thursday morning, and we'll do that right after this for Bargin Power Sports.
Bargin Power Sports invites everyone to come visit their unbelievable new showroom on Highway 301 South in Jessup and on Highway 341 in Brunswick. They have a great selection of ATVs, golf carts, mowers, and more. Bargin Power Sports carries Arctic Cat four-wheelers and side-by-sides, the new popular Can-Am four-wheelers and side-by-sides, cruise carts, and Yamaha golf carts. Bargin's has the full line of Kymco scooters. Don't forget, Bargin Power Sports offers a complete service department for all your service and repair needs. Stop by today and check out Bargin Power Sports, Highway 301 South in Jessup, and their new location on Highway 341 next to I-95 in Brunswick.
Your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Thursday morning. Happy 32nd birthday to Cassie Robertson. Cassie Robertson picks up the cake from the Jessup Walmart Bakery. That certificate's here at the station. We come by and you pick that up, head to Walmart and claim your prize. Bargin Power Sports, Brunswick, Jessup online, BarginPowerSports.com, brings you birthdays and anniversaries. Wishing Cassie Robertson happy 32nd birthday, Big Dog Country birthday cake winner. Good morning for WIFO-FM at 7:33, 27 until on this Thursday morning. Bob will check local sports, state news from GNN in the mix, as well as your weather forecast, and so much more on this Thursday morning. Thanks for waking up with WIFO-FM, the Big Dog in Jessup.
Happy birthday.
Cassie Robertson, 32, picks up the cake from the Jessup Walmart Bakery in WIFO.
At Woody Folsom Ford Baxley, the question is not how are your Super Duties configured. The question is, how do you...